Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Morning Markets on Tuesday, the 3rd of March. Interesting development in the US overnight. We saw the US market close up very strongly on the back of a number of information points that we touched on yesterday. One, the activity or the more coordinated activity from global central banks, but also as the day unfolded in the US, there was it came to be known that there was going to be a G7 finance ministers and central bank call today to discuss sort of some probably more coordinated action that could be taken in the face of the coronavirus and the impact that that's having on the global economy. The positive environment that we saw in the US overnight hasn't fed into as strong a markets in Asia or Europe at this point in time. Of note, in Asia, Japan was down overnight. Why is that? We've touched in these morning markets previously on the impact of the consumption tax increase and how that has been feeding through into the Japanese economy. We've seen the weaker manufacturing data in February, and what we've seen overnight is weaker consumer data out of Japan, just again speaking to the impact of the consumption tax increase last October and the impact that that's having on the Japanese economy. Elsewhere in Asia overnight, we saw the RBA in Australia cut rates by 25 basis points from 75 to 50 basis points. Their statement suggests that they're trying to be a bit proactive in the face of the coronavirus, highlighting the impact that that's having on the Australian economy. It's also worth bearing in mind some context there around the impact that the bushfires that we all saw over the course of the past number of months, that also will have had an impact on the Australian economy. Turning closer to home, we've seen Brexit negotiations effectively start on Monday, and we've seen the UK set out its trade discussions that it wants to have with the US. We've touched on this previously. This will be a long, drawn-out process over the coming months, something that we'll have to be aware of from a headline perspective, but we'll again speak to market volatility as we go through this process of negotiating trade agreements with a number of partners over the coming months and years, for that matter. A couple of weeks ago, we had our podcast, Doing More With Your Money, thinking about the US election. We touched then on Super Tuesday. Well, Super Tuesday it is today. We see 14 states in the US go to the polls to elect effectively the Democratic nominee. We'll see how this process evolves over the next 24 hours. It's really interesting to note that a number of the candidates that we spoke about in the podcast a couple of weeks ago have now dropped out. So there are now five candidates left seeking the Democratic nomination. So let's see how this plays out over the next 24 hours, and we'll come back and discuss a little bit more about this, hopefully tomorrow. Thanks for watching.